happen. But if I press this, I'm hoping that the show will start.
I think we're ready.
Welcome to the Late Tonight Show, starring Pete Sheriff, with our very special guest, Rosala. And we look at the crazy Christmas holiday gifts. And now, live from Solihull, just outside Birmingham, just off the A45, please welcome your host, Pete Sheriff.
Yeah, that worked. That worked. Look. Fantastic. Good evening. Welcome to the show. This is the Late Tonight Show. My name is Pete Sheriff, and we're here. We've got a fantastic guest coming up in a few minutes' time. Rosala will be here talking to us about her life, her career, and all that stuff. We've also got Matt Bullock coming on a little bit later on. He's told me he's not coming on until 20 to 9. Thanks for that. Thanks, Matt. Thanks very much. Pete Gibson is around as well. He's doing the production thing in the back. He's right back there somewhere in the studio depths of Flashback Radio. If you're joining us and you're wondering what the hell's going on, we're live on the radio, all right? And now, if for those of you who are of a certain age, you will remember James Whale used to do a very similar thing on TV, on proper telly, where he would be on the radio and on telly at the same time. And this was a thing that people couldn't quite understand at the time, because it was the mid 80s really, and no one could kind of get their head around what was happening. So I thought, I know what I'll do. I'll try and do the same thing and see what happens, see whether it works. And the technology, let me tell you, the technology, I've got things balancing tonight. I've got things balancing. I've got like a camera balancing on there, because let me give you a bit of advice, right? Don't use a GoPro to do live streaming. It don't work. I've tried everything. New batteries, new charger. I think this thing has just given up the ghost tonight, because it went. And then Pete went, your picture's gone off. Ah, you see? I told you, I got stuff balancing everywhere. You can see. If you want to get in touch and you want to come and now, will that stay? Won't it? I might have to call downstairs in a minute and ask for some sellotape to keep that where it's supposed to be. Now, if you want to get in touch tonight, you can. By a number of different ways. I have to click this now. Look, you see, I've got other things to play with here. Captions. If I press captions. Oh, I think our guest is here. Thank the Lord, she's come to save the day. If I press captions, you can get in touch. You'll see the number appear here on screen. It's 0121 318 8688. And that gets you through to us here in the studio. Wherever you are across the planet and across the world, you can get in touch if you use the +44 if you're outside the UK. We're happy with that. And I can stop sweating now because our guest is here, which is fantastic. So I'm going to let her get ready and get into position. And I'm going to play some of Rosala's hits. If you don't know who Rosala is, or you've just passing by and you're wondering what the hell's going on, this is who we're talking about.
Rosala!
That little X Factor thing going on there. Hello, Rosala, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Oh, we're very well, thank you. Thank you for coming on to the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So I was panicking because I was trying to get you on my iPhone and it's saying whatever's not supported. I went, oh! And it said it's only going to work on a laptop. I quickly went and got my husband's laptop and he helped me. So sorry for the delay and sorry for making you sweat.
No problem. I don't mind sweating over you. It's fine.
Excellent.
So how are you? Are you okay? How's lockdown been for you? Has it been okay?
It's been very strange, Pete. It's been so weird. Yeah. But we've been months in now and it is what it is. You know, what to do. Just take care of yourself.
Yeah. You've been successfully, by the sounds of it, managing to make some music while lockdown's been going on.
Yeah, well, you know, I've been working on an album for the past, I guess you could say, 2 years. We released Turn on the Light probably 18 months ago, 2 years ago, which just carried on doing well and well. We had about 600 stations that playlisted it, you know, so Gary Energize said, just keep letting it run. And then we released Magnificent deep in the heart of lockdown about the 4th of May this year. So although it sort of raised a profile and did okay, I have to say something interesting, Pete. It was a little difficult because there were no DJs to send it out to.
No, sure. Absolutely. Just rely on radio stations.
Yeah. So that impacted how, I guess, well it could have done. So, it caused something. It kept the profile. And we weren't able to shoot a video, stuff like that, you know. And then we decided, you know, moving forward, we released this other new track called I Feel It Slipping Away. And before lockdown 2 came in, Ash Stanley said, we got to do a video. So we all dashed down to Derby. He's got this massive studio. And there were just the three of us in there, you know. And we managed to do a video, for which I'm grateful to Ash. He pushed for it.
I love that video because it's just you. It's just you, and that is great because it's a few sparkly effects. But Nick is just, you know, there's a little bit of a clip of it there on your intro, but I do have another clip of it here so people can hear it. But obviously, we have to keep it real because we get copyright strikes from all over the place. So I'm going to play a little bit of it and let people hear it. That is a proper poppy dancey song. That is you've done it right there. Is that the GMT mix, that one?
That is a GMT mix, and I have to tell you something how this song came about, Pete. Phil, what's his name, from PWL, you know, the PWL that used to do Kylie Minogue, Pete Waterman's label. Phil Harding, actually, he was one of the producers, and he's still strong in the studio and stuff like that, and he had this demo. And his good friend Gary, and he sent it to Gary, and Gary said, oh, I need to send this to Rosella because we're working on an album. And he sent this demo. It had never been released ever. And this demo was probably done sometime in the 70s. And and I loved what I heard. And, you know, obviously we put it up to modern times and get mixes and stuff like that. But I could hear the skeleton of the song being so good. And on top of it, I found out that it was written by Lamont Dozier, writing royalty, you know. They used to write for all the Motown greats, Stevie Wonder, Diana Ross, you name it. And I believe, I looked it up, he's about 89. And he personally sent a message a couple of days ago saying how blessed he was that I covered this song and that, you know, Energize Records is doing it as well. And I just really felt so touched by that.
Yeah, it is a it's got soul to it. It's got, and I mean that in its most literal sense, not necessarily soul music, but it's got something about it. That hook is fantastic.
Yeah, I think that's down to Lamont Dozier and all the Motown artists. I think it's got a feel of that, and of course, you know, all the other different mixes take it to a different level of sound. But this particular one, it's kept that ingredient for sure.
You get this going on when you.
You got it, yeah.
So let's go back, right back to the very beginning of time, and how, because obviously everybody knows you it wasn't your first single though, was it? Everybody's Free. It wasn't the first single, but. I'm sure it's fair to say it's one of the biggest 90s dance records ever. I mean, it ranks, you know, firmly at a Butlin's gig, for instance. It ranks firmly up there at the one you can play that will take the roof off.
Yeah. So,
let's go right back in a bit. How did you start in the business? How did you start singing? How did you get here? Because you're from Zambia, right?
Yeah. I was born in Zambia and I grew up in Zimbabwe. You know, and all my life, Pete, I just wanted to be an international singer. You know, that's all I ever wanted to do from day dot. You know, so it's been in me for practically all my life. And we moved to Zimbabwe. To cut a long story short, I joined a group. And we went across the Zimbabwean country, you know, singing covers of other songs that we heard on the radio station, you know, Western songs. Yeah. I was about 18 or 19. And then there's a talent contest going and I joined the talent contest and I won all the heats. And the prize was a recording contract with the local record company. And that's where my recording career began. Mm. There was a producer that happened to be down in Zimbabwe on holiday and he saw one of my videos on TV. And he's like, oh, you know, I'd like her to come down. I think she's got a good voice. And one of my friends worked at one of the biggest radio stations, and he believed in me. And the three of them, including my record label in Zimbabwe, all put some money together, you know, God bless them all, and bought me a ticket to come to the UK to record stuff in Wolverhampton, actually. And we were sending it round to record labels, trying to get a record deal. And, you know, one of those fell on the lap of the Band of Gypsies, Tim and Nigel, who loved my voice. And, you know, I got to meet in with them. They asked me what I want to do. What am I looking at? I said, look, I want tracks that are uplifting. They've got a good bass line that, you know, when people hear them, I want them to feel they can stand up and dance if they want to, or clap their hands or tap their feet. And more importantly, I wanted lyrics that were positive.
Yeah.
You know, and so you can listen to the whole Everybody's Free album. It's real life positive stories, you know, and that's what the guy managed to achieve for me.
Wow. It is certainly you can't get, there's no album, there's no mix, there's no whatever you, if you say 90s, that is one of the ones that comes from. And it must be such a great fit. I mean, have you ever been anywhere where they've not recognized you and it's been on? That's my question.
I don't know. I think I would sort of hide my face. So nobody recognizes me. And I mean, it probably used to happen in the earlier days when my videos were played on MTV and they were played everywhere. You know, I get recognized on the tubes. When I was, you know, catch the tube, stuff like that, I get recognized when I was walking up and down Oxford Street. And I have to say, as flattering as that was, it was quite disconcerting. And I didn't really like that aspect of it, you know. It was a bit like, oh, I'm being watched. So that part was, a bit weird for me. But fast forward to now, I don't get recognized. And that is absolutely fine by me. Occasionally I do, which comes as quite a shock, you know. Like, I think it was a few weeks ago, I was standing in Marks and Spencer's and some lady tapped me on the shoulder and I thought she was going to ask me what is in the grocery store, and I said yes, and she went, you're that singer that used to sing. She says, used to sing, and you did Everybody's Free, I remember you, are you still singing? I'm like, yeah. So that just totally throws me, but I find it, you know, it's very flattering. You know, it's very uplifting, and so far, you know, I don't really get recognized much, but apart from when I do my gigs, and then of course the people are expecting me to be there and to come on stage, and that's where the hardcore Rosetta fans are. So yeah.
How have you found the reception? Obviously, working on a new album, which is great, and we can't wait to get it. What has the reception been like for you? Coming back into it, because you've never really gone away, have you? But now you're sort of pushing a new song, and the reaction, obviously, it's a little bit different because you'd have to do things on Zoom, you're not going to radio stations and all that. So the reaction from people, now you've got something new out, what are people receiving it well, or are they is it mediocre? We love it. I mean, we've got it on the playlist on Flashback Radio.
And oh,
we,
thank you. We love
it. And it's on, I think he's going to tell me in my ear now, but I think it's on three times an hour.
Ooh, that is incredible. Well, thank you so much. Yeah. I have to say, Pete, we released it on Monday, you know, yeah. And, you know, before that, we started sort of getting it out and promoting it and sending it to DJs and stuff like that. The feedback so far has been brilliant. I mean, you know, it's currently at number 18 on the iTunes vocal chart.
Wow.
There's a promoter in America, they go by the name of Kings of Spin, and they send it around to all the stations. It's just coming today that it was voted by their DJs in their top 30, and it's at number 2. So, you know, the feedback has been just incredible. Mm. Absolutely wonderful, really. Yeah.
Oh, that's really good. That's really good to know, because you are a legend, of course. You are a legend. It's only fair to give you the respect that you're due.
Thank you. Honestly, thank you.
So how many songs are you through in the production of the new album? When can we expect it? Come on, tell me.
Let me tell you, with this lockdown, things have been a case of stop, start. Not sure where to go, not sure what to do. But fortunately, you know, Gary and I were thinking we'd have about between 12 to 15 tracks on the CD. And when we last counted, we got another 2 more tracks left to record. So we're still out there looking for songs. Yeah. We've got a couple that we think will be suitable. And then the rest of the other singles are being mixed currently, and that's how we were able to, you know, put the follow-up to Magnificent out, which is I Feel It Slipping Away. And we've probably got another 2 more, or several more, I don't know, it depends on what mixes come back, to release before the album is due out in 2021. So basically it's just bidding us time. And you know, and hopefully, please God, if, you know, I Feel It Slipping Away is out there for a few months, it bids us the time for me to go into the studio and work on the other songs and the album without having to rush it.
Well, fair play for you for keeping going, because I know a lot of music producers and that are sat with their feet up, not doing a great deal at the moment. But fair play for you, because you're doing it, you're out there, and the song is great. You know, this current one is a real, and I would assume that it will enter into the chart on Friday as well. I think it'll be cool. Is that a noise coming from you? Oh, hello. We're losing your signal. You disappeared then for just a second, but you're back now, so that's okay. All right. Well, look, brilliant. I really appreciate you coming on the show. I'm one of your biggest fans. You know that. We've done stuff together on the sort of Butlins.
I know that, my darling. And I'm your big fan too, and I follow you. And I just want to say my biggest heart thank you to you, Pete. Really, thank you.
No, you're very welcome. You're very welcome. Thank you so much for coming on the show. And hopefully we'll get you on again. We're going to take a break over the Christmas period, and then we're coming back in January. But I'd love to get, when the album comes out, I would love to get you back on and get some more tracks from you and get you going that way, because I think that would be fantastic.
Definitely. What would be even better is for me to come into your studio in person, and we can do this album thing together. That would be amazing.
Well, I've got one question for you. Do you have any, obviously, when lockdown is finished, have you got any plans to do any festivals or anybody talking to you about doing anything? Because I'm sure the people...
Definitely. I've got some stuff in the diary already. You know, I had about 70 dates in my diary for across this year that have been... Some have been moved to next year. Some have been cancelled. But we've got some stuff starting in March, but it's all a wait and see game. But we have some stuff out there, and definitely there'll be some live gigs that I'll be doing in the new year for sure.
Yeah, I think we're on about doing some online live gigs as well to replace some of the ones that we've missed and get some of the artists on. So we'll be talking to you about that and get you on there as well. That'd be great.
I would love that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the legend that is Rosala. Give her a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Rosala, thank you so much. And don't forget,
thank you.
It's Slipping Away. Rosalía's brand new single is out now. Download it. Let's get it to the top of the charts, and we're going to play that snippet one more time before we say goodbye to Rosalía. Rosalía, thank you, honey. Thank you.
Thank you, darling.